Hello and welcome to your astrological vibrations for Monday, December 28th, 2020 by Gaia Blooming. I am Mimi and our energy mantra for today is I work with the divine flow purposely. I've tripped over this mantra several times. Maybe it's my lack of flow right now that's causing that. Anyway, we want to be working with the flow, knowing the divine flow is taking us where we need to go, aligned with our purpose. Divine flow, that is, not getting caught up in, in the whirlpool effect from everybody on the planet. So, back to our regularly scheduled planning, let us do a brief overview of the week ahead. So the biggest thing this week is shifting out of 2020 and into 2021. Now, I am more in alignment with New Year energy beginning when we shift into Aries in March, around, the equinox. However, I think that we can use a doorway, we can use a portal at any time that it's offered. And so we as a world really do celebrate New Year on the 1st, and we have that incoming, right? But again, I think it's really important to remember, because sometimes we can get so fed up with ourselves that throughout many different cultures and religions and ways of thinking, there are multiple opportunities for New Year. So keep that in mind. However, we are completing this cycle that we have known as 2020. Woo, right? So that's going to be pretty major. And we definitely have a few opportunities this week for some lessons. So I think the biggest thing we have this week is a full moon. We have a big full moon in Cancer on Tuesday, 7:28 p.m. Pacific time. Full moons in Cancer can bring out the emotions. Now it's interesting because Capricorn can try to be like kind of more controlled in its nature, and yet the full moon in Cancer is gonna bring it. So pay attention, be aware of that, and be aware of what energies, emotions want to be left behind in 2020. What do you need to still process from this year? This is definitely giving us an opportunity for that. We also have on Wednesday, and this feels potent and important, we have a square between Venus and Neptune. And this square between Venus and Neptune is also coinciding with the nodes. So we have the nodes being worked by Neptune, squared by Neptune, and we'll have Venus sitting on the south node. So what I would say is, especially with the full moon energy, be very aware of your coping methods. Be very aware of overindulgence. Be aware of any idea of or feeling of need of escapism, and see how you can be present with that which is coming up. See how you can love on that energy that's coming up. Because between the south node reminding us of old habits, old patterns that we followed, and Venus in Sagittarius, there is a tendency towards overindulgence with that. And that plus any heightened emotions could not be fun. So awareness of that is probably really important this week. Also, we'll have the moon shifting into Leo this week. Are we beginning the year? We're beginning the year with a moon in Leo. But now when we have Leo transits, we're going to have opposition with the Aquarius. Now it's really important to find our balance between the Leo Aquarius vibes. Any opposition planets, they do can support each other rather than take away from each other. And remembering the lessons of Leo will only serve to support the Aquarian lessons, the lessons of staying connected to the heart. So keep that in mind. Also want to mention, just because I think this is really interesting, our first transit on January 1st, our first and only transit, is actually with Mercury and Neptune. So Mercury in Capricorn, Neptune in Pisces. And I would say that is setting us up to be very aware and conscious of illusion energy. So keep that in mind for 2021. So that being said, let us look at today. So today, not too much going on. We have the moon moving through Gemini, connecting to Neptune. So much Neptune stuff this week. Again, be aware of illusions. Be aware of any escapism tendency. So moon square Neptune, also engaging the nodes. So here we have the north and south nodes. It's actually a bit of a T-square. This to me is opening up that portal to be very aware of what patterns you keep falling into? What is the hole that you fall into over and over and over and over and over again, pattern-wise? Look at these three cards that I have together. I have Rebirth, I have the Fool, and I have the Master. With the energy of the Master, you can have a rebirth in regards to that. You can have a Fool moment, and the Fool moment is like not stepping into the hole, but rather taking a new path through honoring your mastery, through honoring those higher lessons. So I would say with this, become aware of this energy, because it is going to be, like I said, rocking us through this week. So that feels really, really, really important. Where are you being called to shift a long-held, and this could be even multiple lifetimes with Neptune involved, but a really long-held pattern that is no longer serving you? And with Neptune again, if you're not aware of it, be willing to look at any place where you may be practicing escapism. Not that that's a bad thing, but again, that awareness could bring about major change for you for this week. So that feels really powerful. The other connection that we have today is the moon connecting to Mars. So Gemini energy connecting to Mars. You may actually have some Energizer Bunny energy coming through with that. It's happening later in the evening. But between moon and Gemini, which wants to do all the things, let's keep going, let's do this and this and this and this. And then the Mars energy and Aries, whew. Take a pause, make sure that you're not following those old patterns first, the mastery card. And yet, you know, if you have something that you want to get done, that's some energy that can pack a little punch in for you with it. So that's it for today. Let's look at these cards, these other two cards. This blooming card feels like the full moon energy, and the source card. Again, we are building into this full moon energy. It can bring up a lot of emotions. This card is like, get grounded, be present for yourself, be present for any fears that are coming up. The source card always reminds me of root chakra energy, which, you know, can bring up survival stuff. So be aware of any survival fears coming up. And this, the Queen of Pentacles, is like, how can you feel abundant? How can you feel blessed? That may even be part of the shifting of the pattern. You know, the indulgence of lack energy, or indulging so much in lack energy rather than really recognizing your true abundant nature. So be aware of that. That may be part of that Venus Neptune energy as well incoming later this week. So that is it for today. You can book a reading with me. Email me, mimiclark@gmail.com. Besides that, the better it gets, the better it gets. There's more than enough love in the world for you. You have the power, and stay curious. And I just forgot to mention, 2021 readings, I'm still going to be doing them all through this week and all through next week. So if you still want one of those, please reach out and let me know. Namaste.